In this lecture, we are going to do the settings in the grids, okay? And after that, we are going to model the grid in the next lecture. So let's see how we are going to do that. So first of all, right now what I will do is I will select, I don't need these elevation, so I will shift and then again select this one, select these elevations. So what I'm gonna do is I don't need these elevations right now, so I will just simply delete that one, and it will tell you just delete viewpoint, delete anyway. So we are going to set these things later, okay? And after that you have to select and cover all these elements here, and after that we are going to delete this one as well. So right now we are at the ground floor, and if you want to create the grid, what you can do here is that you can just scroll to this document, okay, and after that you will get this tool here, that is grid element tool. You just simply need to click on that one, and after that you're going to get these options here, okay? So if you want to access the setting of this one, what you can do is you can just simply select out this one, or what you can do is you can just simply type Control T from your keyboard, and after that this setting will appear. So as you can see here that this is the grid element default setting. If you look here, you will see that this is the grid element line, okay? You can see that this is the continuous line from this end to this end. If you look at this one, you will see that this line has is discontinued from 1 meter segmented line, okay? And if you look here, you will see that you are going to only see the end of this grid line, okay? As you can see here that right now the segment length is not available, so we will stick with this line, okay? And if you look at the shown story, you can see that all story are selected. It means that if we are going to model this grid in any of the story, we are going to get the same configurations in all these stories, okay? As you can see here where we have these stories. And if you look at the marker, you can see you can mark this marker as well. You can see the marker is something like this. So if you only want to see only one side of the marker, you can just untick that one, and then you will get rid of that marker. Now this is for the floor plan, okay? Now if you look at the section and elevation, you will see the configuration is almost same that of the floor plan, okay? So let's go to the next one. Now here in the naming rule, you can see that you can either go with the custom settings, or you can generate the names automatically. As you can see here that this naming will start from A and that will goes up to Z. And here in the style, you can see that we have these options available. We have a numerical value as well. So that's totally depend on you that what exactly the system do you like. And now let's go to the marker. So if you look at the marker, you will see that we have this marker pen, we have the thickness, we have the text pen thickness, and all these things are here. If you want to change this one, you can change that one as well, but right now I'm okay with this setting. After that we have this text style. So you can see you can just control the text style, you can choose this one to any of these font. You can see that this is Western, you can change this to any of these. And here you can see you can make this one bold, italic, underline, okay? So all these settings you can do in text style. And in 3D you can see that we have these things. So according to that, if you want to make any kind of changes here, you can make any kind of changes as per your project or as per your requirement. So after setting all these things, what I will do is I will just simply click on okay. So in the next lecture, we are going to see how we can model the grid.